इसलिए अब पोएम बाय फैज अहमद फैज. सो हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे राइट. The snow-covered mountains, the lush green gardens, the sparkling waters of the Dal Lake. This was the crust that was equally dark and rotten from inside. Welcome to Kashmir, the land of living death. It was December 1989, the time when snow covers the land and the sins of people. And here, Rafiq was burying his brother Kamran's half-burnt leg. So Rafiq is a person, right? He's a central character of this story. And he, at this point, he was burying apne bhai ki aadhi jali hui taang, wo dafna rahe the, right? Kamran was a well-thought of shopkeeper at Goni Khan Market, a guy with a wrinkly face, always smiling, always assisting. His thoughts remotely pertained to the problems of Kashmir or its azadi. All he cared about was his family and ways to bring in some bucks. When asked if he plumped for India or Pakistan, he always responded with Faiz Ahmed Faiz Shair. Hum dekhenge, lazim hai ki hum bhi dekhenge. Jab zulm o sitam ke kohe gharam, रूई की तरह उड़ जाएंगे हम महकूम के पांव तले ये धरती धड़ धड़ धड़केगी और अहले हकम के सर ऊपर जब बिजली कड़कड़ कड़केगी हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे. That day there was some tension in the city. Militants had killed some army personnel and there was a latent hostility in the eyes of Indian forces with regards to the indigenous people of Kashmir. The atrocious wrath was to be poured on the common non-violent people of Kashmir. Every shop in Lal Chowk was shuttered down at 2 in the afternoon. Kamran also closed his shop and took along his thermos flask and sachubol. As he reached the Hari Singh High Street, he saw Ammut, a maniac, puffing a cigarette. He poured the chai and offered it along with the sachubol to the Ammut. In Kashmir, mad people are saints and saints are considered mad. But regardless, of who is who, both are immensely respected. He poured the chai and sachur and offered it along. Kamran sat there waiting for the mood to finish the tea and return the cup. On the Amira Qatal bridge, some heads popped out a distance. In no time, almost 50 men in khaki shorts appeared out of nowhere. They carried hockey sticks and whiskey bottles in their hands. Any and everything that came their way was either broken to pieces or reduced to ashes. Seeing the drunken military men coming close, Kamran found himself sheltered inside a cleavage of two buildings. Waiting for the ranger to pass, Kamran could hear occasional banging and smashing. The violent military mob came closer. They greeted the Mot, or as they preferred saying, Baba, and kept walking. None among them saw Kamran, but then someone among them screamed at the top of his voice, "Yahan chupa hai," he's hiding here. Like stray dogs jump on a piece of bread was exactly how these men pounced on Kamran. He was kicked and slapped and pulled from the cleavage and thrown on the road. This was their way of saying hello. Now the talking began. One among them got on Kamran and smashed his hockey stick on Kamran's interior teeth, these friendly three. Others kicked his abdomen, chest, hip, back, shoulders, etc. Others broke their hockey sticks on his legs. The worst part was that Kamran was not yet passed out and every bang he was feeling with complete intensity. They rested for a while and watched Kamran, who by now was making no movements. One of them came close and checked if he was still breathing. Yes, he was. He was crying. Not because of the pain, but the thought of how his mother would be heartbroken when she comes to know how ruthlessly her son was beaten. He examined his body to see which scars could be kept hidden from Mochi. He imagined his hot-blooded young brother Rafiq. How he would react when he sees his brother beaten to pulp. Blood was oozing from his mouth, teeth, legs, and where not. He was conscious, but had no strength to move. He couldn't move. He was trying to try something, all in vain. One among the khaki shorts came forward and poured the whiskey on Kamran, on his face, on his head, chest, legs, etc. This was an attack on his spirituality and faith. As Kamran had never in his life touched alcohol. It's haram in Islam, it's forbidden in Islam. Before he could say or ever think of any other thought, he was burning in flames, alive, screaming, Mojai, Mojai Mor Hussein, Baya Mor Hussein, Mojai, Mojai, Mother, Mother, they killed me, Brother, they killed me, Mother, Mother, Mother. With these screams, Kamran died. What remained of him was nothing but a half-burnt leg that right now Rafiq was burying in Mazar-e-Shuhada, the graveyard of martyrs. The Imam completed his prayers, and what followed was slogans of freedom. Azadi, Azadi, Azadi. It seemed that the graves too joined the slogans of freedom. The tombstones vibrated with all the shouting, as if the men were banging the graves from inside to get out and fight the war of Azadi. Only one person among all the people was rock hard and completely silent. Rafiq, jo ek kamran, jisko mara gaya, uska bhai Rafiq, he was silent. He was reading something from a small paper, as if he was saying some prayers. His expressions bore no sign of hate, anger, guilt, sadness, or misery. But his eyes did. His eyes were a clear sign that a tempest storm was to come. He threw the small paper from which he was reading something and kissed his brother's grave. The paper danced in the tones of cold air before it fell on the grave of Kamran. Rafiq returned home to console his mother, and on the paper was written, "Hum dekhenge, lazim hai kahenge."